Hi all, welcome to Tech Forum. In our previous videos, we have seen how to set up AEM server with cloud storage, but the setup was enabled with a new AEM instances. In this video, let us see how to migrate the existing instances to cloud storage or S3 bucket. I'm going to use AEM 6.4 for this demo. I'm already having an author instance and also uploaded some sample images so that we will be able to verify this after the migration. So it's a author instance with additional some images. It's again a fresh instance for me, so I just uploaded one or two assets so that we will be able to verify it later. So also refer the previous video for complete steps on configuring the AEM instance with S3 bucket. Here I am not going to explain the complete setup, like setting up the S3 bucket and S3 connector and all those things. So here the only difference is going to be the repository migration from the existing instance. So we will be migrating the existing repository to the this new server. So also they can ensure the server is stopped. We will start this migration process. Let me go and stop it and go. Okay. So also one more thing to note here is, like, I tried to configure the existing server with the required configuration and the run mode, but unfortunately that no FDS run mode was not considered for the existing instance. The option is to build new instance and enable the no FDS run mode and migrate the data from the existing instance. Okay, as a first step, like, we need to configure the S3 bucket and also required user and policies. So I already did that. Maybe on the previous video I explained it. So I created a bucket with the name AEM S3 repository and also configured the required policies and user. Here only one difference to notice, like, I created this bucket with the US West, North California. Somehow the CRX2Oak tool, whatever we are going to use it for migration, so it was not considering the East, US East, Virginia, S3 location. So I created with the US West. So that is the only difference. So otherwise all these steps are going to be same as what we explained in the previous video. Okay, like, now we need to then as a next step, what we will do is, let we need to what I created is, I've created a folder called old. So this is the actual server what is now running. So now I created another folder with the name new. So here we are going to configure the new server. Okay, so for that, what we need to do is, like, first we need to unpack the server. So what are the steps we followed? Okay, unpack is completed. So next up, we need to configure that install folder. So already I downloaded the connector and configured it in the same we explained in the previous video. So here I just took one paste that. Yeah, so let me open it quickly. Yeah, this access key, secret key, then the bucket name, then the region is the best one. So remaining configuration, most of the configurations are going to be same. Now what we need to do is, we need to start this server. So for that, we need to execute this particular command, same thing whatever we were earlier using it. Okay, so I'm going and starting the server. Enter the admin password. This will take some time, so let us wait for the setup to complete. So means, like, all the upload is completed. So it is better not to stop the server in the middle, so otherwise it will create some problem. So you can monitor this particular folder. Your repository folder will be created and you will be able to see the download, dump and upload folder. So wait until that upload folder is empty and all the server is started. Okay, just keep monitoring this log, so you will be able to see this kind of messages, repository data store upload. So also one more thing is, go inside this quick start, you will be seeing a folder called repository. Under there is another folder, repository data store. You will be seeing this download, upload, item folder. If I go inside the download, yeah, 255 items downloaded, and also if I go inside down upload, so 256 items should be uploaded. So wait for some more time. So once the upload is success, this folder will become empty. So let's wait for that. Also the server should be starting now. So once that is completed, then we can go with the migration activities. Okay. Now the server is started. Let me verify whether it started properly. Okay. Yeah, that's fine. Server started properly. So maybe we can close this, it's not required. So but still this upload is going on. Let's wait for that to complete. So even we can stop it and start it, because anyway we are not going to use this data store, we are going to migrate it. So what I will do is I will stop the server and we will start with this data store migration. What I will do is, as a first step, let's stop the server. I'll go and I will stop the server. So what we can do is, like, we can wait until this repository folder is created and this data store and segment store is created. Also verify this segment store and blob ID, these all folders are created and the server is successfully started. So then you can go and stop this server. Okay, stop the server. Now what we need to do is, we need to do the migration. So for that, what you need to do is go inside this CRX Quick Start repository segment store. Just to rename this segment store with maybe old. Same way, go inside this repository folder, rename this data store again to old. Okay, this is fine. So now what we need to do is the same thing. We need to go to this S3 management console and to empty this bucket, because the default instance, whatever we installed, would have created some blobs. So go to that and empty this. Okay, S3 repository 1. I'm going and clicking here, confirm. This may take some 2 seconds. Okay, fine. This is empty now. So now what is the next step is, we need to perform this migration. For that, go to this particular, yeah, we need to execute this command. So we need to go inside this opt extension, the new instance, whatever we built it. So go into cmd. So if you see here, so you can see a jar with the name crx2o. So that is the tool we are going to execute. So this is the command you should be executing, crx2o.jar. Then you have to select the copy binaries. Then source data store. So this is the data store folder from the source repository. So my case, the source repository is this one. So I will go under author. It's a old. This is my source repository, my source author server. Yeah, keep this data store location here. Then we need to keep the S3 config location. So that is under my new instance, under the install folder, just to refer the full path for this config file. Then another one is the S3 data store. So this is the data store path where this cache folders are going to be get created, the download, upload and all those things. So that is under this new. They always ensure this repository slash another repository, because always by default the no FTS run mode is creating under this repository and again one more repository folder. So I'm going to use the same path here. CRXT quick start, new repository and data store. So this is the source repository path. So old here I am mentioning, then under till the repository. This is the new repository path, new CRX quick start repository. Okay, so let me go and execute this now. Okay, this will again upload all this blob IDs to the S3 bucket. So it may take again some time, so we need to wait for that. Also, what if you, yeah, if it started. So if you go here into the new instance, so if you go under repository, yeah, new segment store is created. you can just see this. Okay, it's getting migrated. Also, if you go under repository, new data store is created, download, yeah, same activity, 25 items, yeah, this upload. So let's wait for this activity to complete, so then we can perform the next activity. Okay, the upload is migration is completed now, so you will be seeing this message. Also, if you go into this upload folder, so all this blob IDs are deleted. Also, let us go to the management console. We see like 2476 objects uploaded. Okay, now let us start the server. So we'll go to this and stop it. Okay, you can use the same comment whatever we are using here. Okay, let's wait for the server to start. Okay, the server is started now. Let us log in. Okay, let me go to assets, files. Yeah, if you see here these two assets, it was from the older server, so it got migrated to this new server. So this new server is now configured with S3 bucket for data store. So one more activity we can perform is like, we can let us upload one new file here. Okay, maybe before that let me go to this console and ensure what is the final object count. 2476. Okay, 2477. So let me maybe download, upload another image. Okay, let's wait for some seconds. Okay, the image is processed here. Now let's go to the S3 console. Maybe it will take some time. Let's wait for that. Maybe let me request from there. So if you see the count increase 2480, so it means whatever the new image we uploaded and it got uploaded to the S3 bucket. Okay, this concludes the migration of existing AEM instance to S3 bucket. The same approach can be followed even to set up with Azure data storage. Thanks all for watching the video. See you in the next video.